What can you do with these to take ice climbing farther? You don't know what's gonna happen. And that's what I like best about climbing. If you know what's gonna happen, then what's the point, right?
I'm in full ADD mode right now.
It's gonna work out great. I kind of wanted a pink one, but they don't have a pink one of my size. This is gonna be safer. Well, a little bit anyhow. Just because it doesn't work at first doesn't mean it's a bad idea, right? There's possibilities here.
Yeah. Oh, brilliant.
Well, it's true. If it doesn't work, then the next step is to find something that does work, right? Obviously.
I'm not the seeing the convinced look in your eyes
not
at all.
Same.
All right. So everything you need to go exploring at Helmcken Falls. Got prototype ice screws. These don't exist anywhere else in the world. They're extra long with thread all the way because it might hold better in the really soft ice, but normal ice screws are never gonna work. 2 years ago at Niagara Falls, we made these things. And this looks a lot like a Spectre, except it's got a big shovel on the back. And the theory is that you can pound this into the soft ice and then it will hold a fall. Maybe they'd work here. And you could climb up on into this cave of hanging icicles, hanging kind of styrofoam icicles, spray ice. It's really theoretical. You know, the warning in the box said basically, we don't take any responsibility for this. This is not a Black Diamond product. You're on your own. Didn't say you're an idiot for using these, but the subtext was pretty clear there actually, so yeah.
This is the secret weapon for finding roots.
But before we can even climb, we have to go down into the canyon and kind of beat our way in there. It's challenging getting down in there. It's not your normal ice climbing area. And you walk out of the parking lot, cruise along the lip of the canyon, drop down into another little canyon with a mini rappel, and then do a free hanging rappel, and then you come around this corner and there is Helmcken Falls. It doesn't matter how many times you've been here, you see Helmcken Falls and it's like, whoa. This is real. This is the business.
Look at it all and figure it all out too, right? Like, that's a safe place to be.
The big hazard is that there's all these super soft icicles over your head, and they weigh tons, and they break off from the spray that keeps accumulating on them. That's probably the number one hazard down here. They break off all the time. Tim Emmett and I came here for the first time 7 or 8 years ago, and we thought it was a great idea. Everybody else thought we were nuts. We managed to climb up these kind of broken off icicles using bolts for protection. But what would be cooler than that? How about not using bolts? How about doing it on natural gear? If we could find some way to protect it, then we wouldn't have to leave bolts in the rock, and that is always cooler.
But yeah, if we could get up like 15, 20 feet today, that would be a good accomplishment.
I'm sure I trust the system.
Oh, Sarah, there you go with the voice of reason again. Now, if you're here, you've already gone off the path, right?
I just think it would be good to knock this thing down, a couple of these, just so that the Blair is feeling
more protected.
The Blair, aka me.
So they're not very solid.
I just don't feel comfortable belaying you to climb towards nothing. I think I'd rather test the gear with some bolt protection first.
It's getting dark, we should probably get out of here, eh?
I want to climb this thing today. It's colder today, I don't want to mess around with it. I want to get it rigged, and if I can get some more pins in and figure out a few more bits and pieces on the way up. Then...
Bingo! I found the bolts!
Just look at these things, and they're just not very confident.
No, I mean, they hold body weight, but would they really hold a fall?
I really don't think so. I think you don't want shoulder pads.
It's scary, I'll admit it. Like, if this stuff blows at me, it's gonna be pretty real, right?
Yeah,
like,
it's not gonna be fun.
I don't wanna be a pioneer anymore. Oh, I feel like a little kid on a diving board. I just don't think good things are gonna happen.
Oh,
ugh, that hurt. Ugh, right between the shoulder blades. Ow. Yeah. Technology that I thought was gonna work isn't working.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm just frustrated, you know? It's...
That's good.
V-thread test, everybody ready? V-thread test in 3, 2, 1, launching. Yeah, something actually held. That's great. Those are good to go. Got V-threads all the way up there. And it's pretty real climbing, you know, but it's the first time I've ever placed an ice tool, an ice screw and a Spectre all tied together for a piece of my life. Plan for tomorrow is to climb this thing on natural gear, and that would be pretty cool. That's what we came to do. I don't think I've ever left an ice tool on a climb as protection before. That's new. Paying attention to that. Whew, that's cool. An idea in reality, you know? Like, that's pretty cool. I'm really excited. Like, the V-threads were good, and the combo Spectres were good, and the ice tool left in the ice for protection is pretty good too, I think.
I'm glad it's done, and we didn't have to retest any of the gear. That's a good thing.
Fun to get your mind stretched, get your head messed with, and this place always does it. From the very first day that we came in here until now, every day has been kind of a mind expander, you know? This place, so cool.